Hey, what's up, guys? Today, I'll show you a horror film, Art of the Devil, Part 1. Spoiler ahead, watch out and take care. The movie starts with Boom, a young girl who has an affair with a married man named Prathan. She takes revenge because Prathan doesn't acknowledge her and leaves her devastated. Man, one of Prathan's children in his first family, is running towards her mother's room while holding a box. She is terrified upon seeing that her mother is vomiting blood. After a while, she hears the phone ringing, so she immediately goes to her youngest brother's room and finds out that he is also covered with blood. She answers the phone, and the person on the other line is the reporter, who tirelessly helps her in solving the mystery over the deaths of her loved ones. He tells her to get out of the house because the killer is her sister-in-law named Boom. All of a sudden, Boom hits her on the forehead, causing her to lose consciousness. Boom sits down beside Nan, whose hands are tied. She asks her to sign the property transfer papers, but Nan refuses and asks the reason why she is doing this. Boom starts telling the story behind her revenge. Boom didn't kill Nan yet because she needs her to sign the papers that will transfer the inheritance to her. She believes that she deserves it after what Prathan did to her. In a flashback, Boom meets the married man Prathan and his friends in a country club where she is working. Afterward, the two begin an affair. Boom finds out that she is pregnant, so she immediately tells Prathan. He is not happy with Boom's pregnancy and questions if he is the real father of the baby. He asks Boom how much she needs in exchange for her silence. Out of disappointment, Boom asks for a huge amount of money, which Prathan gives. Suddenly, Prathan changes mood and tells Boom to stop crying because he will not leave her. Prathan doesn't have any thoughts of continuing his affair with Boom. Boom wakes up very surprised upon seeing Prathan's friends behind the window. Prathan tells her that he has the right to share her with his friends because of the huge amount of money that he gave. Boom tries to escape, but they are too strong for her. Prathan heartlessly takes video while his friends humiliate Boom. Boom visits the doctor for an ultrasound to check the baby. She is so shocked when the doctor informs her of the baby's situation. She goes to the restaurant where Prathan and his family are celebrating his youngest daughter's birthday. Before she enters the restaurant, she talks to her friend via phone call, and she advises her to have an abortion because she is sure that Prathan will not adopt the baby. But Boom refuses and tells her friend that she will keep the baby no matter what. Unfortunately, according to the doctor, the baby has abnormalities and will not have a normal life. Soon after, Boom interrupts the celebration by telling Prathan that he needs to give her additional money. The family doesn't seem surprised at all when they see Boom. Prathan drags Boom out of the restaurant, then slaps and warns her to stay away from his family. He throws money to her face, then shouts that it will be the last time that he will give her money. The family there was not surprised when they saw Boom, because they are just Prathan's second family, and the woman is also a mistress, just like Boom. After 6 months, it is aired in the news that Prathan's friends who raped Boom died one by one mysteriously. The reporter finds the case interesting, so he follows the case to find out the truth behind their sudden death. One day, while Prathan is making out with another woman, he suffers from a severe headache, which feels like his hair is being pulled out. Then at his mansion, his youngest daughter suddenly wakes up because of the noise coming from the window. She is very scared, so she runs downstairs and hides inside the bathroom. After a while, Prathan's second son comes home drunk with his girlfriend. When they are inside the room, he hallucinates and sees his girlfriend as an old woman, so he strangles her. When his girlfriend runs, he grabs the gun, then shoots her. When he checks the body, he is very surprised to see that it is his girlfriend. Out of disappointment, he shoots himself as well. Meanwhile, Prathan's first son is walking on the street. When all of a sudden, he vomits a lot of blood, then falls down. It is aired in the news that Prathan's second son shot his girlfriend and youngest sister, then killed himself, while their mother is found dead because of a heart attack. Prathan's first son is also seen dead on the street. Later on, Prathan's dead body is found in his beach house. Cuts were seen around his head, and nails were found near his body. It is revealed that Boom asked the help of a shaman who performs black magic in killing Prathan and his family. Boom visits the shaman to give him the payment. He tells her to donate coffins to the temple, which is equal to the number of the people she killed, so that the spirits will not bother her. Boom goes to the temple and follows the shaman's instructions. When she is about to go home, a rescue car passes her by, and she is very surprised to see the spirits of Prathan and his family at the back of it. Suddenly, a car hits her. The court decides to give the wealth to Prathan's first family, which makes Boom very disappointed, so she thinks of a way to get the wealth to them. She befriends Nan, and successfully becomes the girlfriend of Ruby, Prathan's eldest son and his first family. Prathan's first family excitedly moves to the mansion. The helpers gossip that the mansion is very creepy, because Prathan's second family died there. Nan sees a ghost in the bathroom, but just ignores it. Her youngest brother also plays with someone, which they cannot see. Nan goes to work the next day. Her friend asks her if she can still see ghosts. But Nan answers that she was just tipsy that time. That's why she saw weird things. Her friend tells her to go to the temple to get rid of the bad luck. Nan refuses, but her friend is persistent, so she doesn't have any choice but to agree. After work, they go to the temple and talk to a person whom they called Master. The Master prays over Nan and casts out bad luck. Afterward, they offer food in the shrine, but a beggar eats it. Unfortunately, the beggar who ate the offering went crazy. They think that the curse was transferred to him. The day of the proposal comes. Boom patiently waits for Ruby outside the jewelry shop. When he goes out, he bravely asks Boom to marry him. Boom is very happy, because her plan to enter the family is successful. The day of the wedding comes. The second son is busy taking videos of the wedding's preparation when he suddenly sees a child running upstairs. At first, he thought that it was his youngest brother, but he is surprised when he appears beside him and asks if he sees his friend. He goes upstairs to check it, but decides to ignore it and just continue taking videos of the preparation. Nan is very close to Boom. She even sewed Boom's wedding dress. However, the whole family is unaware that nightmares are waiting for them. After the wedding, the family decides to stay in a resort. Nan tells her friends that she is bothered by the black magic email that she received. Her friend tells her that it is better to follow what the email says than to be sorry. The brother gets curious and asks Nan the content of the email. Nan answers that according to the email, you should not answer anyone if they call out your name, because if you answer, the spell will be transferred to you. The brother says he doesn't believe it, but ignores Ruby when he calls out his name. Afterward, he goes to the bathroom and takes a bath. When he goes out, Boom enters and gets his hair on the floor, which she will use in black magic. Meanwhile, the youngest brother hands over drawings to Nan. Little did they know, those drawings will happen to their second brother in real life. All of a sudden, his stomach aches, so they rush him to the hospital, where he is diagnosed with ulcer. One night, Nan suddenly hears a noise in her second brother's room. She checks it, and she is very surprised to see that he is being smothered by eels. Unfortunately, her second brother died after 3 months, and the doctors confirm that he passed away due to illness. After the death of the second brother, the reporter approaches Nan and tells her that he believes that her family is cursed, and they are in danger. So Nan goes to the reporter's house and is surprised to see his research. He believes that the death of Nan's father is connected to her brother's death because the spell was transferred to him. At first, Nan cannot believe it, but the reporter convinces her because it also happened to him. In the past, when he had an x-ray, the doctor saw a cleaver in his stomach, but nothing was found when they operated on him. He also adds that their wealth might also be the reason why someone wants them dead. After hearing all these, Nan suddenly suffers from an asthma attack. Going back to the present, Nan asks Boom if she really loves her eldest brother. Boom answers that Ruby is her only love. She then begins to narrate how she killed him. Ruby falls in love with Boom because of black magic. But things change when Ruby sees a doll, which is used for black magic in Boom's baggage. She thinks of an alibi and says that she uses the doll to ensure that they will love each other until the end. Ruby laughs and assures Boom that he loves her with or without the doll. Later on, Boom feels that Ruby is suspecting her, so she asks the shaman to create a spell that will give Ruby illness. During their ritual to pray for Ruby's recovery, he suddenly vomits blood with blades before collapsing. But the people only see blood, not the blades. When Ruby was cremated, they find blades on his ashes that convinces Nan that their family is cursed. One day, when Nan checks her youngest brother in the room, she is in shock to see a white child playing with him. The white child asks Nan to play with her as well, she suddenly disappears. The brother says that she is the friend who teaches him how to draw. The drawings reveal the evil plan of Boom. Afterward, Boom asks the shaman to create a spell that will make the mother lose her mind. Because of that, the mother sees ghosts that tell her that she will die next. The reporter finds out what happened to the mother, so he asks a priest to bless the house and cast out the spirits. The priest tells Nan that a spirit is following her, but she just wants to play. Unbeknownst to them, the white girl is behind them. The reporter starts to suspect Boom, so he follows her. That day, Boom goes to the country club, hospital, and to the house of the shaman. Boom feels that the reporter is already suspecting her, so she orders the shaman to kill him. While the reporter is taking a bath, the glass suddenly shatters. When he goes out of the comfort room, he accidentally steps on the broken glass, which causes his foot to bleed. Suddenly, he receives a phone call from the hospital, informing him that Boom is not pregnant, and she cannot bear a child. Soon after, he feels pain in his leg, and finds a moving object going up to his body. He hurriedly gets a knife, and cuts his skin despite the pain to get it. Luckily, he successfully gets the broken glass inside his stomach before it is too late. They thought that Boom is pregnant with Ruby's baby, but it is revealed that she cannot bear a child anymore after her miscarriage caused by a car accident. Even if the doctor told her that the baby has abnormalities, she still wanted to continue the pregnancy. But because of the accident, the baby died, which further intensified her anger to take revenge. She brings the baby's dead body to the shaman. He performs a ritual, then puts the body inside the box. It is revealed that the white child, who plays with the youngest brother, is the child of Boom who died. One night, while Nan is sleeping with her brother, the white girl wakes her up and asks her to play. She is very scared and screams to death. The white girl runs downstairs, and it seems like she wants to show something to Nan, so she hurriedly followed her. After a while, Nan sees her in the bookshelf, then she suddenly disappears. She checks the shelf and finds a box. When she opens it, she is shocked to see a baby's dead body. What's more, when she checks the death certificate, she finds out that it is Boom's child. That is the time when she hurriedly runs to her mother, while carrying the box with the dead baby, and then she finds out that Boom is the mastermind. Going back to the present, Boom drives Nan to her mother, and warns her that she will end up like her if she disobeys her. Suddenly, Nan suffers from an asthma attack again. Boom helps her, then forces her to sign the papers. Nan kicks Boom, so she hits the wall, which causes her to lose consciousness. Fortunately, the reporter comes and takes the mother outside the room, while Nan goes to her brother. Unfortunately, Boom escapes. She contacts the shaman to inform him that the reporter is alive, asking him to kill the reporter again. In the hospital, the doctors find out that there is a small animal inside the youngest brother's abdomen, and it is getting bigger. They conclude that the child may have swallowed it accidentally. Nan panics when she doesn't see her youngest brother in his room. She looks for him, and luckily, she finds him in an abandoned building with the white girl. After a while, she sees her mother vomiting blood with Boom. Boom gives a gun to the mother, and orders her to shoot Nan, which she obeys. However, the mother comes to her senses in time, and realizes that she is about to kill her daughter, so she shoots herself instead. Meanwhile, the reporter rushes to the shaman's house and shoots him, ending his creepy life. But unfortunately, the doll that has a spell for him accidentally burns, which causes the reporter to blaze on fire as well. Nan pleads to Boom to spare her and her youngest brother, but Boom refuses, telling her that they should die in order for her to get the inheritance. Unfortunately, Boom slips on the edge of the building when she is about to stab Nan. Nan reaches for her hand, and helps her to climb. But the white child, Boom's dead daughter, appears and nods her head to Boom. Boom finally realizes that she needs to stop and end her revenge, so she lets go of Nan's hand. She falls on the building and dies. Nan hurriedly goes to her youngest brother, who is on the edge of the building, and is about to fall down. With the help of the white child, the youngest brother gains consciousness before it is too late. The movie ends with Nan recording in the house of the reporter, confirming that the reporter's research about black magic is true, because it happened to her family. This is Daniel CC Movie Channel. Stay safe and enjoy your day.